Hello, this is year 3 and 4 Fundamentals and Ball Skills. This is lesson 2, and we are going to get warmed up. Why do we get warmed up? Someone tell me. Yes, well done. To get the blood pumping and to get our heart rate up and to reduce the injury. Let's go.
Okay, follow along with me. I'm going to put the music on.
Right, let's get started. This is lesson two. We're going to be moving on to a few more skills today, but let's just recap on what we did last week on last lesson. So, we have throw and catch above our heads, so making sure that we're watching the ball as it goes up and on the way back down. So you're going to do 10 with me now, so let's go. So, up, making sure our hands are together, watching the ball all the way up. Two more. Nice, that's 10. Great work. So, and also we did clap catch. So we just did one, making sure we're still looking. And then we did as many as we could in a short amount of time. So now we're going to be moving on to doing a backwards clap. Okay. So, first of all, what we're going to do is you're going to make sure that you're throwing it up and down like you were before. Just have a few practices of that. Then practice your clap in between. And now all it is doing it behind your back. So you throw it up and clap. Make sure we're watching the ball the whole way. And our hands are together, ready to catch it. So we're going to try that together now. I'm going to try 10. Here we go. Two more. Superb. Now you might want to go into the garden or just be a little bit careful of how high your ceiling is because you do have to throw it a little bit higher than what you were with the other catches. Now you've tried that, we're going to try and do it front and back. Okay? Seems a little bit harder. Now I would recommend going into the garden for this one just because we're going to have to throw it a little bit higher to get both claps in. Alright, so we start here. Still watching the ball, still keeping our hands together. So we throw up. You throw if you want to. Nice, so let's try 10. Obviously, if this is too difficult for you, doing behind the back and in front, you can pause and rewind the video, or pause the video while you practice it some more, not following along with me all the time. Or you can just go back to doing one clap. Or you could even go back to last lessons and practice the skill from last lesson, then come back to this lesson. That's completely fine as well. Two more. Superb. Very, very, very good job. Next up, we're going to do some combinations. I'm going to show you a few of mine, and you're going to give them a go. So to start with, we're going to do throw up, clap on the one leg. On the one leg. Now if you're good at that, you can go on the two legs before you catch it. Now remember, still looking at the ball, keeping our hands together when we're going to catch, and cannot drop on the floor, must not bounce. Okay? So we throw up, try the one to start with. Now if you find that too easy, now to the two. There's one more that I want you to try as well. I call this head, shoulders, knees and toes. And the best thing about this is that you can progress from your head all the way down to the toes. So we can start with just the head, touch your head, still watching the ball, hands together when we catch, then head, shoulders. Then head, shoulders, knees. Then a big one, head, shoulders, knees, toes, catch. No bounce in between, okay? Give it a go, 30 seconds. You got me where you want me. Come up with your own combination. your own movements. But rules are, you must be watching the ball as it goes up, your hands must be together when we catch, and it cannot bounce. Must do it before it hits the floor. Alright, so we've done the under the leg. We've done the... Now what we're going to do, I'm going to give you one more before you have your 2 minutes, is we're going to do, I'm going to try and do the floss. Alright, your turn, 2 minutes, go.
Have a little break if you need to. Shake off your legs because you're down there for a long time.
Take a deep breath and then we go again. 1 minute, just practice it. Remember, the flow is important. Very well done, that's our 1 minute up. How'd you get on? Cool, superb. Now our target for this is 12 in 20 seconds. So one is round one leg and round the other and back to the starting point. So that's one. We need 12 of those in 20 seconds. Should we give it a go? Let's do it. 20 seconds starts now. See, I got my 12. Did you get your 12? Superb. Great work. Now, if you didn't get your 12 and you found it difficult, remember, pause, have more time to practice if you need to, or if you're struggling with the skill altogether, go back to last lesson, practice last lessons, or practice what we've done before today, then come back to this point, all right? Our next skill is around the waist and then the figure of eight. So, we've practice both of these skills separately, so we've practiced round the waist and we've practiced the figure of eight, but now it's about putting them together. Alright, so we're going to do a few together. So get your ball, we're going to practice together. So we're going to go around the waist and figure of eight. Now just remind me, what are the most important points, key points about when we're doing these skills? Great work. So we are making sure our legs and our feet are shoulder width apart. We're bending our knees. Okay, so just go around the waist. And then figure of eight, around the waist, figure of eight. We're going to practice three of these together, me and you. Okay, so we're going round, figure of eight, back to our waist, round, figure of eight. One more, round, figure of eight. We've had a practice, so now the target for this is 10 in 20 seconds. So we're going to have a go at that now. So remember, going round, all about the flow. Leg shoulder width apart, knees bent. 20 seconds in 3, 2, 1, go. See, I only got 9 in there. How many did you get? Great work, guys. Great work. That is our second skill. So round the waist, figure of eight. Let's move on to our last one, which is, this one is probably the hardest we've done so far. Not probably, it is. I struggle with this one. What you have to do is you have to have one hand in front, one hand behind. And what we're going to do is, you let go of the ball for a second, and you swap your hands in positions. So if this hand was in front, it then changing, going around the outside of the leg and going behind. Alright, so we're just going to have a little practice of this one, because this one is very hard. So, if you need one, and as you're practicing, we're going to have a bounce in between. Practicing that motion. Having a bit more time to catch the ball balance. So just the bounce. Let's go for 30 seconds just practicing that. With me, get your ball with the bounce. Are you ready? Go. Remember, the legs should be shoulder width apart still. Knees bent. Arms go around the outside of our leg, not on the inside. Remember, you need a little break. Shake off a little bit, and then we go again. 30 seconds. Now the quicker you can get at this, the easier it is going to be for you to transition into the catch. So we've had a little practice. Now we're going to try 30 seconds again, actually trying the skill, the drop catch. So same motion, however, there should be no bounce in this one. So it has to be a full catch. Still go around, so our arms are still going around the outside. Our legs and feet are still shoulder width apart and bending our knees. Here we go. 30 seconds, 3, 2, 1, go. Now if you drop one everyone to the wall, it's just a practice, so it doesn't matter. Remember we're going outside the legs. There we are, dropped it again. There's our 30 seconds, good practice. How many did you get? Okay, so now your target for this one is just being able to do 5 without it hitting the floor, without it bouncing. So that means doing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 of those, that's your target for that skill. Final part of the lesson now, and we've got something fun as we always do. We've got a family challenge. So you need to go and get a family member. So you can just put my mask on. There we are. This is my family member for today, Georgia. Okay. Now, it's gonna be just like when we did our flow, go around the leg, but you're gonna do it with your family member. So our feet are gonna be together, and I'm gonna go around Georgia's leg, round my leg, and then I'm gonna step back with my leg, and George is going to step forward with her back leg. So we're just going to go here. Then we go round again. And then we go back. Round, okay, then drop it. Round, and then back. Okay, cool, cool, cool. So, I would say, you need to go out of your garden for this one. Or if you go out for your hour exercise to the park and do this, you need to set one point and a second point, and you're trying to see how quickly you can get from one point to the other, okay? You can do this in your house if you have enough space, but if not, garden or for your hour exercise, go to the park. And you need a family member, make sure you've got your family member, okay? You guys, pause the video and go and do that now. Recap time now, so let's have a look at what we've done this lesson. So, we first started off with our behind the back clap. Okay, just practicing that. Then we did our forward to back, or back to forward, whichever one you'd like to do. Now remember, still looking up at the ball, still putting our hands together to catch it, alright? Then we did our combinations, so we did our clap on the leg for one, we did two. Then we did our head, shoulders, knees and toes. Then you had your own combinations, you did your own, and I'll show you my plus one. Then we moved on to our main skills. So we did our figure of eight, which you need to hit 12 in 20. Then we did around the stomach figure of eight, which is 10 in 20. And then we finished off with, I think the hardest one we've done so far, the throw in the middle, going around the outside of the legs. Still with our feet and legs are shoulder width apart, knees bent. And remember, for this one, you can have a bounce in between to practice. Now that is everything for today's lesson. Make sure you pause, rewind, take as much time as you like learning the skill. Go back to watch last lessons if you need to. And I've been JJ from Fiesta, and have a good day.